Hello children, welcome to another session of science class 4. I'm your science teacher and today we will see a video on food, our basic need, and we'll do a revision of lesson 1. Objectives of today's lecture are students will be able to define food science and will be able to understand how food science research is used and applied. All living beings need foods. Animals, birds, plants and human beings need foods. Plants make their own food through photosynthesis process. Eating good food, especially with family and friends, is one of the pleasure of life. We all know that people who eat healthy and balanced diet usually grow well. We need energy. Energy is the ability to do work. We can define energy as the strength to do any kind of physical activities like skating, boxing, cooking, bathing, grooming. We all need energy for these activities, which is supplied from your diet in the form of calories, food like fruits and vegetables. The food that we eat has many substances that help our body to grow and stay healthy and strong. The substances that are needed by our body for energy, good health and proper growth are called nutrients. Nutrients give us energy to do our work. External functions supported by energy includes exercise, work and play. If you are active and doing a lot of physical work, you need nutrients which help us to prevent us from falling ill too often. Food items such as cereals like rice, wheat and corn, and vegetables such as potatoes give us a lot of energy. They contain carbohydrate. Food items rich in carbohydrates are called energy-giving food. People who do a lot of physical work, such as laborers, farmers, and sportspersons, need a lot of carbohydrates to give them more energy. Food items such as milk, egg, cheese, fish, meat, beans and pulses are rich in protein. Food items rich in proteins are called bodybuilding food. They are needed for the growth and repair of our body and also for building muscles. Food items such as nuts, oil, ghee and butter are rich in fats. They provide more energy than food items rich in carbohydrate. They also help to keep the body warm. Our body needs very little fat and extra fat is stored in the body for later use. These are different sources of fats: butter, ghee, nuts and oil. Sources of carbohydrate are rice, sugar, wheat, maize and potatoes. It provides energy for doing different activities. Proteins are required for the proper growth. Sources of proteins are egg, fish, milk, paneer and pulses, and are also called bodybuilding food. Milk and fruit are also very important. Food items such as fresh fruit, vegetables, egg, milk are rich in vitamins and minerals. They protect us from diseases, and there are 5 types of vitamins. Vitamin A, which improves eyesight and keep our skin healthy. Vitamin B is needed for various functions of the body. Vitamin C helps to fight infections and keeps our gums and teeth healthy. Vitamin D helps in proper absorption of calcium in our body. Calcium and iron are examples of minerals. They help in formation of bones and blood. Example of calcium rich food items are milk, curd, almond and cheese. And example of iron rich food item are green leafy vegetables and dry fruits. Water is also very important. Water is very important part of our diet. Our body needs water for all its function, perform many chemical reaction, removes waste, regulates body temperature. You should drink 8 glass of water every day. Food items such as cereals, corn, green leafy vegetables and fruit contain fiber that cannot be digested by our body, which is very important. A diet that has all the nutrients in the right amount, dietary fiber and water, is called balanced diet. The picture shows some food items that make a balanced diet. In order to stay healthy, we should eat food items from each of the food groups like carbohydrate, proteins, vitamins and minerals, and fats. By mixing fruit and vegetables with salt and oil, we can preserve mango, lime, and other vegetables. This is the method for preservation of food. There are so many ways for preservation of food. First is drying method. By removing the water content of the food, we can preserve food. Second is refrigerating method. By keeping food in the fridge to preserve it for a short time, for example, keeping cooked food and fresh vegetable in the fridge, we can preserve fish and meat by preserving them in the freezer. Last method is canning and bottling. By storing foods in cans and bottles, we can preserve food. Exercise are also very important. They are important to stay healthy. Regular exercise and playing outdoor games makes our body fit and muscles active. Exercise burns extra fat off our body. Our heart beats faster during exercise and improves blood circulation. The sweat during exercise makes our body clean and cool. Postures means body position. It is important for us to keep our backs upright while standing or sitting. Incorrect posture over longer period of time can lead to pain in joint and muscles. Our body needs rest for proper functioning and doing different activities. We need 6 to 8 hours of sleep in a day. For doing activities like studying, playing and going to school. So from this we can say that all living beings like birds, animals, plants and human beings need food for doing different activities. As we know, human beings are depend on few basic needs for living, without which they cannot survive. These basic needs are food, including water, shelter and clothes. Food is our basic need. We cannot live without food. It gives us the energy to work and play. It makes us strong and healthy. It helps us to grow. It protects us from diseases. Even your brain needs a constant supply of energy to continuously maintain, support and protect your life. Mental activities such as work, reading, studying, homework, learning new language needs a lot of energy. Food is essential for our body to develop, replace and repair itself. Food provides us energy to work and play. It protects us from diseases and helps to recover fast and from illness. We eat different food items, and each food items contain different substances. These substances that provide nourishment essential for the maintenance of life and for growth are called nutrients. Now let's understand lesson through few slides. Human beings are depend on few basic need for living, without which they cannot survive. These basic needs are food, including water, shelter and clothing. Food is our basic need. We cannot live without food. It gives us the energy to work and play. It makes us strong and healthy. It helps us to grow. It protects us from diseases. Second basic need is shelter. A human being needs shelter to protect themselves. They need house to protect themselves from rain, cold, sun, and wild animals. Another basic need is clothes. Clothes are one of the basic need of human being. Before clothes were made, man used to cover him or herself with skin of animals or bark of tree or with leaves. Eating good food, especially with family and friends, is one of the pleasure of life. We all know that children who eat well usually grow well. What is energy? We can define energy as energy is the ability to do work. Eating, bathing, grooming, working, engaging in passionate pursuit, you need energy, which is supplied from your diet in the form of calories. Energy fuels your body's internal function, repairs, builds and maintains cells and body tissues, and support the external activities that enable you to interact with the physical world. Your body's most important nutrients is water, which helps facilitate different kind of functions. We need energy for studying also. Your brain needs a constant supply of energy to continuously maintain, support and protect your life. Mental activities such as work, hobbies, reading, studying, homework, doing crossword puzzle, learning a new language. All this thing requires energy. External functions supported by energy include exercise, work and play. If you are active and have a high lean body mass to fat ratio, your energy needs are greater than someone who leads a modern life or has a high body fat composition. Some of the energy is also used to help us grow. As kids grow from grade schooler to preteens, there continues to be a wide range of normal regarding height, weight, and shape. Kids tend to get taller at a pretty steady pace. Growing about 2.5 inches means 6 to 7 centimeters each year. When it comes to weight, kids gain about 4 to 7 means 2 to 3 kilogram per year. Normal growth, supported by good nutrients, enough sleep and regular exercise, is one of the best overall indicator of child's good health. Your child's growth pattern is largely pushing kids to eat extra food or get higher amounts of vitamins, minerals, or other nutrients will not increase their height and may lead to weight problems. Many people want strong and healthy hair, especially as they grow older. Your hair grows around 0.5 inches means 1.25 centimeter per month, and 6 inches means 15 centimeter per year. How fast it grows depends on factors like age, health, genetics, and diet. Although you can't change factors like age and genetics, diet is one thing you have control over. Muscle is the body's most metabolic tissue, which means it requires more energy than other body tissue to maintain itself. Because they are naturally more muscular, men need more energy, calories, than women do. Children and young adults undergoing development changes in height, weight, and body composition have greater energy needs. The key to healthy eating is to enjoy a variety of nutritious food from each of five food groups. Five food groups are in the proportion that you should be eating them throughout your day. If you eat a variety of foods from each of these food groups, your body will receive all the nutrients and vitamin it needs to function. Foods from the basic food group provide the nutrition essential for life and growth. These foods are also known as everyday foods. Each of the food group provides a range of nutrients and all have a role in helping the body function. First food group is carbohydrate. Carbohydrate provide energy for the body. We need energy for all activities we do. Carbohydrate include sugar, starch, which found naturally, and other foods such as fruits like apple, banana, grapes, vegetables. They contain carbohydrate. Food items rich in carbohydrate are called energy-giving food. People who do a lot of physical work, such as laborers, need a lot of energy as they do a lot of physical work. The laborers spend 8 to 10 hours working with hammer and other tools in the agriculture field, construction site, and other places where physical labor is required. The diet of the laborer must be a combination of different food groups. For providing the instant energy for muscular work, the carbohydrate in the form of sugar and starch are required, which are converted into different energy. Next food group is protein. Food items such as milk, egg, cheese, fish, meat, beans, and pulses are rich in proteins. Food items rich in proteins are called bodybuilding foods, as they help us to build our muscles. They are needed for the growth and repair of our body and also for building muscles. The food items which are rich in protein are food grains, pulses, peas, egg, meat and milk. Young children need more protein-rich food item than adult because they are still growing. Food items such as nuts, oil, ghee and butter are rich in fats. They provide more energy than food items rich in carbohydrate. They also help to keep the body warm. Our body needs very little fat. Extra fat is stored in the body for later use. Next food group is vitamins and minerals. Food items such as fresh fruit, vegetables, milk, egg, peanuts are rich in vitamins and minerals. They protect us from diseases and keep us fit and healthy. They are also called protective food. Vitamin A improves eyesight and keeps our skin healthy. Vitamin B complex is needed for various functions of the body. Vitamin C helps to fight infections and keep our gums and teeth healthy. Vitamin D helps in proper absorption of calcium in our body. And vitamin E and vitamin K protect us from diseases and keep us fit and healthy. As like five food groups, dietary fiber is also very important. Food items such as cereals, corn, green leafy vegetables, and fruit contain fiber that cannot be digested by our body. The part of the plant food that cannot be digested is called dietary fiber. It helps to remove waste material from our body. Hence, dietary fiber is very important. Water is also a very important part of our body, which is very important for our body, its function. We should drink plenty of water every day. As like five food group, balanced diet is very important. A diet that has all the nutrients in the right amount. Nutrients like carbohydrate, protein, fats, vitamins, minerals. This complete diet is called balanced diet. The picture shows some food items that make a balanced diet. In order to stay healthy, we should eat food items from each of these food groups. Next is food preservation. If food items are kept for a long period of time and not stored properly, they get spoiled. Such food items are bad for our health. Preservation of food prevents it from getting spoiled. We can preserve food in a number of ways. The first method is food drying method. By removing the water content of the food, we can preserve food. For example, drying grapes to get resin. This is the first method through which we can preserve food. Second is pickling. By mixing fruit and vegetable with salt and oil, we can preserve food. For example, mixing mango, lime and other vegetables with oil and salt. Next method of preservation of food is refrigerating. Keeping food in the fridge to preserve it for a short time, we can use this method of preservation of food. For example, keeping cooked food and fresh vegetable in the fridge. Next is deep freezing method. By keeping food in the freezer to preserve it for a longer time, we can preserve food. For example, keeping meat and fish in the freezer. Next method for preservation of food is canning and bottling. Storing food in cans and bottle. For example, bottling of sauces and jams. Next topic is rest, posture and exercise. As healthy food affect and can improve our health, rest, posture and exercise can also improve our health. Our body needs rest for proper functioning. We need 6 to 8 hours of sleep in a day. Lack of sleep may result in improper functioning of body organs. It can make us fall ill. Therefore, staying up late is not a good idea. As healthy food and rest affect our body, correct and incorrect postures also affect our body and health. Posture means body position. It is important for us to keep our backs upright while standing or sitting, because incorrect posture over a long period of time can lead to pain in joint and muscles. Exercise is also very important to stay healthy. Regular exercise and playing outdoor games such as hockey, football and cricket help us to stay fit. Yoga is also very important. Yoga is an ancient method of exercise practiced in India and also helps in keeping our body fit. We have seen few topics like need of food. Need of food means all living beings need food, want food, and it is basic need. Food gives us energy for doing activities. Then we have seen another topic, food groups. There are 5 food groups: carbohydrate, protein, fats, vitamins and minerals. Then we have covered another topic, dietary fiber and water, then balanced diet. Then we have covered rest, posture and exercise topic, in which we have seen that exercise is very important to stay healthy. So today we have learned about need of food, meaning of nutrients, 5 food groups, meaning of balanced diet and effect of rest, posture and exercise on our health.